Hello my crafty friends, welcome to our channel. I am Anu, designer at Just My Craft, and today I'm back with another craft tutorial. But before we move forward, please subscribe to our channel if you haven't already and hit the bell icon to never miss a video from us.
I recently bought this banner punch from Just My Craft, and in this video I'm going to share my first impression along with that some creative ideas to use this banner punch in so many different ways. So let's begin. Let's first have a look at the punch. This is a big heavy duty punch. On the top here, some banner sizes are mentioned. Here is this the alignment scale. On the back, you see these are rubber grips to prevent the punch from slipping on surface while using. You can punch with this on desk as well as in hands. Now here I have some 250 GSM cardstock cut at 1.5, 2 and 2.5 inches wide and 4 inches long. To cut with this punch, insert the cardstock from here and then press the handle. Use the alignment lines to cut perfectly. These banners are stackable and it gives you a good quarter inch border. Now let's see what else you can use it for. Here I got 3 sentiment strips of 1/2 inches by 6 inches approximately. I am simply punching the edges to make a simple ribbon. For the second one, I am repeating the same thing. This time, I am punching out a small piece only. Now, to make it more interesting, I am going to fold this in zigzag, and this looks so cool popped up. Again, on the third one, punching out a small piece, this time folding it on an angle. This took me a while, but I liked it. Moving on, you can create a lot of decorative shapes to pair with the banner. For example, a triangle. Then a chevron. Then an arrow. Then here's a bow. Lastly, a diamond shape. Now let's see some ways you can place these shapes on a simple banner. Diamond shape didn't go on the banner well, so I will create something else with it later in this video. This is what I left with after making the different shapes, and I thought let's make something with that. So I simply folded this in half, glued down a toothpick in the center and closed it. And there you get an easy peasy flag. Remember the diamond we couldn't fit on the banner anywhere? I decided to make a kite out of it. How? Let's have a look. cutting a fresh new diamond shape. And a tiny triangle for the tail. Some thin strips as well to go on the kite. Now I think this came out really cute, isn't it? Going back to basics, I felt I need to create these cute buntings. So here I got a strip of pink cardstock, punching it normally to make a small banner. Now on the blue one here, I punched opposite way. Now these are two different shapes you get to make your buntings. Look at these, I used funky alphabet dies on these, and you can use this for your cards, scrapbooks and even decorations. Next I went crazy and created random things with it. Right now here I am creating a pocket. For the stitches, I used white gel pen and added two brads on the corners as well. It does look like a pocket, right? Again, using the same punching technique, I am creating a small heart here. For the roof, I am using scallop punch from Dress My Craft. I am gonna add 3 layers of it and then a simple door. I enjoyed creating this one. For the last one, I have cut this with scallop circle punch and this with 2-inch circle punch. Now adhering them like this, I have number 1 cut out, adding it in the center. Now taking a 3/4-inch wide strip and punching it simply, cut it in half and add it behind like so. And this will give you an easy peasy ribbon match. Honestly speaking, the possibilities are never ending with this banner punch. Just imagine and create.
So this was all from me today. I hope you enjoyed this video. If so, do give it a thumbs up, leave some love in the comments and share this video with your friends. Also, all the supplies I've used in this video are linked in the description box below. You can check there. So now I'll take a leave and I'll be back again with another craft tutorial. Until then, see you and happy crafting.